Hello everyone, my name is Mahendra Parmar and I'm going to talk about Train 10,000 Teachers Training Program, which was done under NMEICT, National Mission Education through ICT. The shorter name for Train 10,000 Teachers Training Program is T10KT. Firstly, I would like to talk about scenario in India. There is significant increase in number of engineering colleges and students opting for engineering courses. And you would be glad to know that India is the third largest country in the world in this higher education, but there is lack of access to good quality education. As per one of the surveys, it was found that 2/3 of our Indian universities are of middling or poor standard. So there is an urgent need for skill enhancement for teachers in different subjects and less explored areas. But there is a problem of synchronous training to all these teachers. So Professor Phatak has initiated Training 1000 Teachers Training Program in December 2009. Initially we started off with this EduSat facility, and since it has limited number of remote centers, we switched it to AVU, that is Amrita Virtual Interactive Educational World. And in 2012, when we scaled it up from 1000 to 10,000 teachers, we have partnered with IIT Kharagpur here. So why T10KT? The formal name for T10KT is Empowerment of Students and Teachers through Synchronous and Asynchronous Instruction. Here, training can be provided to large number of teachers at one go. Since this is done through AVU, a lot of teachers can attend from various remote centers from this program. And there is optimal use of ICT with minimum changes in instructional practice. And this T10KT model is cost effective as well. So how we do the STTPs? All these STTPs are coordinated by IIT Bombay faculty. We basically focus on core engineering subjects, and we try to find out the common syllabus of all the universities and accordingly plan our course content. All these STTPs are conducted through synchronous distance mode of training. And we use various innovative teaching methods, and we use the LMS, also learning management system like Moodle and IIT Bombay X. And all these contents after the STTPs are being generated in open source, and it's open for free download. From 33 STTPs which we have conducted from 2009 to 2015, we have covered various domains like computer science, mechanical, civil, electrical, physics, and some interdisciplinary courses like research methodologies, pedagogy, green building awareness, and technical communication. And from this, 1,15,000 teachers have attended our STTPs from this 357 remote centers. So you must be wondering, what is remote center? A remote center is something, it's an engineering institute with a good infrastructure facility, and it has a proximity to a number of other colleges as well. So when we conduct the STTP, the other college teachers can also go and attend the workshop in this remote center. They should have a good academics, that is the departments, the domains which the institute should have, and the faculty. So I'll show you the map of the remote center.
Let me just explain a little bit. Okay. This is not a MOOC. Okay. MOOC means teacher is not present at all. He has done videos and is there. This model initially started as a 2-week workshop. Okay. In the morning, an IIT faculty who is teaching that would be physically delivering a lecture from here. It's not recorded lecture, it's physical lecture. Okay. Now the faculty will assemble at various remote centers, 357, but they have a choice, they need not attend everything. About 200-250 remote centers spread across the nation. Okay. The fact that these 10,000 is never 10,000, it's about 6,000 faculty will join there, listen to the professor's lectures in the morning session typically. Okay. In the afternoon, there will be a workshop. So the faculty is actually like a student. Morning lectures, afternoon workshop. Okay. For 10 continuous, 10 or 11?
10 days.
10 days. Okay. Spread across 2 weeks. The assignments which they have to submit, the group assignments which they have to submit. Okay. Now before this, he just mentioned something like we look at the syllabus. Okay. How can we look at the syllabus? So all the participating remote centers have to send one person what is called as a coordinator's workshop. Okay. So each remote center has a person who has come to IIT for 1 week or 2 weeks?
1 week.
For 1 week, okay, wherein they will sit together, they will decide what are the topics to be covered in that, and this thing used to happen about 2 to 3 months before the final thing. Okay, what topics should be covered, because IIT education is at this level, most of the college education is at this level, so we have to come up with a list of subset of topics which IIT normally covers. Okay, so coming up with a subset, and then the faculty goes and prepares his content. Okay. The coordinator workshop followed by this workshop. So it was a process where the quality of education, the other thing, the reason why we went to AVU, other than other tools that are available, because AVU had something called interactive questions. Okay. So they had each remote center had something where they can say, I have a question. Okay, the professor can be interrupted. Okay. The professor, when he is delivering lecture, sees that this particular remote center has got a question. At one particular time, he will switch back to that remote center. That remote center will become visible to everybody. The person there will ask the question, the professor. So there little bit of interaction, not too much. Okay. When we are dealing with 3,000, I cannot have 3,000 questions. So depending on the faculty's mood, okay, he will take one or two questions per topic so that people don't go to sleep. So that was the model of teaching this faculty.
So this is the remote centers, like from Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari and from Gujarat to Tripura, we have remote centers across the nation. We have covered 26 states and 2 union territories. So the methodology which Avinash sir has just explained to you, remote centers, which I have already shown it to you, people at remote centers are also a vital part of this program. Because they are the ones who are the coordinating person between IIT Bombay and the local participants. We have remote center coordinator and the workshop coordinator. Workshop coordinator, I would like to elaborate here. Workshop coordinator is a subject expert of that faculty, subject expert of that particular course, who basically work as a TA for IIT Bombay, and he or she tries to solve the problems of the local participants. Now I'll talk about coordinators STTP. Before we announce the STTP for the general public, we first make the announcement for this remote centers. They are being called to IIT Bombay. About 200 to 250 participating remote centers come to IIT Bombay. So only one representative from every remote center comes. They are being trained in IIT Bombay style, and the common syllabus is decided here. And after he go back, he announced this to the local colleges, and they do the online registration. And in the main STTP, which is conducted for 2 weeks, that is 10 days, all the local participants come and attend at this remote centers. So this is the process flow. Coordinators STTP, which we conduct 2 months before the main workshop. They come here, then the certificate is given to them. When they conduct the main STTP, the live AVU transmission is done from IIT Bombay to these various remote centers, and local participants can interact with IIT Bombay faculty just in case if they have any doubt. And after the STTP, they have been given the post workshop assignment, and the certificate is accordingly distributed to these participants. So this is the snaps of live AVU transmission. Here, if you see, faculty is delivering his lecture, and in this one of our faculty is interacting with one of the remote centers. So some interesting findings which we have found is like 91% to 92% have indicated high perception of learning and satisfaction. And we have seen that 19,350 plus participants, they are attending more than once in our STTPs. And we have seen that 127 remote centers are the most recurring remote centers. They are interested to attend our STTPs every time when we conduct it. IIT Bombay has also developed this MOOCs thing, which is called as IIT BombayX. I suppose Aparna has already talked about it, but I'll give you the gist of it. We have launched this IIT BombayX on 26th of January 2015. And in this IIT BombayX platform, we have conducted various MOOCs and blended MOOCs courses. Under T10KT STTPs also, we have used this blended MOOCs approach. Here, in the blended MOOCs courses, the teachers are supposed to do the online activity first and then come for the face-to-face component. So in the online activity, they are being shown the videos, pre-recorded videos, and some assignment and quizzes are given to them. And then they come for the face-to-face component. And in the face-to-face, here it is more of interactive and group activities rather than just mere lecturing from IIT Bombay. So this way, like, it is participation from both teachers and from the learners' point of view. So apart from this blended STTPs, we have also done the blended MOOCs courses with 50 autonomous institutes. In our pilot three courses, 50 autonomous institutes have agreed to do these courses, and they have asked their students to enroll in this IIT Bombay course. Here, the teachers are being mentored by IIT Bombay, and they are being treated as the partner for this blended MOOCs courses. So teacher here, the teacher of the remote center can monitor the performance of the students, and accordingly, these grades are being factored in their internal marks. Whatever students score in the MOOCs course are being factored in the internal marks. So what we have generated here, we have content generated of videos, lecture slides, assignments, quizzes. At the moment, the problem here is, like, we have it on multiple sites. It is there in IITB NME ICT website, Moodle, and IIT Bombay. So there is a need for repository. So course content is now it's accessible to very limited number of audience. And even if you want to view the content, you have to access multiple websites. And the search engine is not available on the website, so we have to work upon it. So what is our goal? Our goal is to create a repository which is easy to access in an organized way. Keyword search facility should be there. And just to add all, it should be user-friendly interface so that every user, like whoever comes on our IIT Bombay's website, should get the information at one hand. So how it will help? It will help. Like I was telling you, all the ready course content will be available in open source in one interface. So data should be there in both video and document format. And the learner and the user will get the exposure to IIT Bombay style of learning here. That's about it. Thank you so much.